Hi, good morning children, and welcome to the next video of poetry teaching. And this is Gift of India by Sarojini Naidu. Having presumed that you've understood the prelude to the poetry or to the poem here, it would be befitting if I say that the poem was written in 1915, included in the poetesses, that is Sarojini Naidu's collection, The Broken Wing. So the poem is emotionally and sentimentally charged with the feelings of respect and love for the Indian soldiers. Through the poem, Sarojini Naidu has attempted to pay a homage, a kind of a tribute and respect to the martyred Indian soldiers, and to awaken the people of the nation to cultivate and nurture a spirit of patriotism for their own country. So the poem, as you would find, would evoke a sense of pride as well as a sense of grief at the loss of a number of lives of Indian soldiers in the First World War, precisely. In addition to the pride the mother, sees in her son's achievements over here in this poem, a sense of agony, a sense of melancholia is expressed throughout the whole poem, which is suggestive of a mother's pain on being separated from her children. So that's the pathos has been captured here very beautifully. The Indian soldiers have no real motive to participate, had no real motive to participate in the war except to serve the British people. In literature, students, writers and poets have often glorified war. However, Sarojini Naidu in this poem tries to bring out the futile and brutal aspect of the war also. As I told you, it's an anti-war poem. As she would mention how the dead soldiers are not even given a proper burial. They're not given proper burial. They lie with pale brows and broken hands in alien graves. That's what I've quoted from the lines given in the poem itself. And especially when she says those places where priceless treasures from my breast and yielded the loss, sons of my stricken womb to the dumb beats of the duty, and so on. So the poetess over here has excelled in incorporating a poetic imagery in her poems. As I told you before, in this poem too, we find a number of visual, auditory, and color imagery, which is always quintessential to Sarojini Naidu. Some of you would find my language a little difficult. Of course, you've suddenly got hold of a good lecture in literature, and that is a jump from 10 to standard 11. But children, please don't mistake me. I purposely use words so that you can note it down and you can enrich your vocabulary and use it in daily language too, so that it can beautify your own language, right? So let's begin with the poem now. So the poem begins with a rhetorical question. See, there's a question mark, children. I hope all of you have your books. I don't have a book, so I have opened my system here. So is there aught? Aught means anything. Anything. So is there anything you need that my hands withhold? Withhold is to stop, to hold back, to keep in your hands. So Mother India throws a rhetorical question to the readers. What is rhetorics in English? What is rhetorical question? Questions which are self-answered. Like if a lover boy asks a lover girl, "Do you love me?" So it's self-answered. The girl doesn't need to confirm that she loves, right? So sometimes when teachers often tell you, when will you improve your handwriting? So it is self-explanatory from your side that you would never improve your handwriting, right? So that was a piece of joke that I had cracked. It meant to be laughed at. So here Sarojini Naidu says that is there anything that you would need, that you would want me to hold back? The Mother India is telling us. And would it be rich garments of raiment? Would it be, India, children, was known for silk in those days. The Britishers took away vast quantities of beautiful silk. In fact, as I quoted Shashi Tharoor in his book, he says Indian silk was known as something by the Britishers. It was known as woven air. soft woven air. They didn't call it silk, they called it soft woven air, which can be easily passed through a ring of a thumb or a finger. It was such fine. So India was known for its rich gifts of gold and grain, because it was an exceedingly agricultural country, and clothes. So Mother India wants to know if I should hold back any of these rich things in my hand, either grains or gold or anything. And she says, lo means look. There's an exclamation mark, because she is trying to deviate your attention from the question now. And she gives an answer to that. She says, lo, I have flung to the east and the west, to the eastern part and the western part of the world, I have flung my soldiers. I have given away my priceless treasures. I've given away my priceless treasures torn from my breast. So there's an exaggerated statement, which in English is called hyperbole. The figure of speech that is used here is called hyperbole. The figure of speech used in the first line was a rhetorical question. So Mother India says, I have already given, flung, thrown to the boat, to east and west covers the entire world, to all the parts of the world. And what have I thrown? Priceless treasures which were torn from my breast. My children, who are priceless treasures, is a metaphor. Children, her soldiers, her people have been metaphorically to a metaphor compared to priceless treasures. And yielded the sons of my stricken womb. And I have yielded, I have given away the sons of my stricken womb. My womb is suffering as I see my sons, dead and fighting. To the drum beats of the duty. I have given them to what? To the duty calls, the beats of the drums which were beaten in the war field, the sabers of doom. They were the messengers of doom. They were the swords, for sabers are swords, swords of punishment, swords of death. And I have given my sons to the swords of death. I have given my son to the beats of those drums which were beaten wildly in the battlefield. And for all of it, it's my womb is a womb of a mother which is stricken, which is suffering. And these are my priceless treasures that I've given to the entire world. So here you see how a mother is actually brooding over the loss of her son. So on that note, I would end here. It's already crossed time. So please stay tuned and revise well. See you until the next video.